Hi guys, and welcome back to another Tech Airspace video. Today we are talking about sensor modules that can be attached to your Meshtastic devices. Some models already include sensors from the factory like the LILYGO Supreme or Seed Studio T1000E. However, most devices do not come with any sensors. Today we will be adding a temperature and humidity sensor to WisMesh Pocket and to a T-Beam. By adding environmental sensors to your Meshtastic devices, you can conveniently monitor the data directly on the device screen and in the Meshtastic app. You can also create awesome graph visualizations of your data using platforms like Grafana. I'll be making a tutorial video later which will show you the easy steps how to set up a Raspberry Pi for logging the data and displaying it as graphs. There's a list of supported sensor types on the Meshtastic website. All of these sensors will be auto-detected by the firmware. For this video, we'll be using the RAK1901, which is SHTC3-based sensor, and for the T-Beam, we will be using the SHT31. With temperature accuracy of plus or minus 0.3 degrees Celsius and humidity precision at plus or minus 2%, the SHT31 provides consistent and reliable data for your projects. The SHT31 sensor has 4 pins that needs to be connected to the T-Beam: VCC for power, GND for ground, SDA for data transmission, and SCL for the clock signal. I decided to use header pins to make connecting the necessary sensors or modules more convenient. I will be using jumper wires to connect the sensor. Later, I will also demonstrate how to connect multiple I2C devices to same bus. With the header pins in place, it'll be simple to swap out and test different sensors and modules. Now that the sensor is connected, we need to activate the Environment Metrics module in Meshtastic Telemetry Settings. Click the Enable Environment Metrics Module button and set the metrics update interval. Normally, 900 seconds or 15 minutes is fine, but I set the interval to 30 seconds for testing purposes. Now the device will start sending out the temperature and humidity data to the mesh. The sensor and display can be connected at the same time by sharing the power, ground, SDA, and SCL lines. Next, we'll add the RAK1901 sensor for the WisMesh Pocket. The 1901 offers even greater accuracy for measurements. It has a temperature accuracy of plus or minus 0.2 degrees Celsius and humidity accuracy within plus or minus 2%. This well-made sensor is part of the WisBlock system and it's very easy to install. You simply insert the sensor into one of the WIS connector slots labeled A-F. Before installing the sensor, we need to open the device case and remove the screws that hold the WisBlock baseboard in place. We need to do this so that we can disconnect the battery connector. Even with the power switch off, it's a good practice to disconnect the battery. Now, simply align the sensor's connector with the WIS connector slot and press down until the sensor clicks into place. Be careful not to touch the sensitive components on top of the sensor. I'm using a watch repair tool with a flat plastic head. That's it. Now we just need to secure the sensor with a M1.2 screw. To finish up, attach the battery connector and secure the sensor base plate with screws. To view the environmental data on the device screen, make sure to enable the display option in the telemetry settings. Also remember to enable the environmental metrics module and set your update interval. It may take a while for the first readings from the sensor to appear. With the environmental display enabled, it will now show data from both the device and other nodes in the mesh. Alright, that's a wrap for today. You've successfully set up your sensors and can now monitor the environmental data. If you've got any questions or want to explore anything further, drop a comment below. Tech Airspace out.